Dr. Urban here, continuing to tie together plant lectins, leaky gut, chronic disease, and inflammation, plus the Gundry diet. In another video, I mentioned how we can look at diets through a lectin screen. What are lectins? Lectins are plant proteins which allow certain plants to hack into an animal system in a way that results in killing or otherwise injuring that host. The result is a war in the gut where each side, hosts and plants, are locked in an arms race and war. Lectin proteins are designed to give plants an edge by making the host ill or worse. How do lectins hack our system or our body's systems? The grand plan of lectins is to escape the gut and attack the distant organ systems via the bloodstream. Think of it as being in a corridor, the sides of which are made of chain link fencing. The lectins must breach the chain link fence, making holes large enough to let the lectins out. The lectins have the ability to attack the places where the links come together to decouple these junctions. The lectins pry these links apart, making their holes, allowing the lectins to escape into the bloodstream. As the lectins escape, so do other bits of bacteria, partially digested food, lipopolysaccharides, etc. Collectively, this debris from the gut is injurious to the host. Instead of chain link fencing, let's now go into the gut. The chain linking is replaced by one layer of gut lining cells, which are linked at certain points, like that chain link fence. Lectins target these junctions and flip them open, causing gaping holes in the gut lining. Can you see how leaky gut comes about? Once the lectins and contaminating substance are in the bloodstream, they invoke an inflammatory defensive response, which can become acute and chronic, leading to many of our chronic illnesses. So much so that growing evidence suggests chronic illnesses and their flare-ups begin in the gut. It may come as a surprise to discover that many of our so-called healthy foods are full of lectins, which are greatly detrimental to our health. Lectins are poisons. Do you see why I suggest that if your diet is not dealing with the lectin factor, something major is missing in that diet? Use the presence or absence of addressing the lectin factor as a critical screen for all diets. Dr. Stephen Gundry, MD, has a book called The Plant Paradox. In the book, he explains in greater detail the lectin dilemma factor, plus he identifies common lectin foods. You'll be surprised by which foods are on that list. Consider getting Dr. Gundry's book, The Plant Paradox, so that you can maximize the benefits of your diet. Notice that I did not mention calories, glycemic indices, nutrient groups, probiotics, etc. There is a link to Dr. Gundry's book in the description below. Lectins are poisons. So going forward, what are you going to do about lectins? That's it for this video. Subscribe to my channel as more health videos are coming. I am not a spokesman for Dr. Gundry, just grateful for what the Plant Paradox diet did for me. Remember, lectins are real and out to get you. Change your thinking. Robert Urban. Do not make any changes to your healthcare regimen without first consulting your healthcare providers.